Hey, everybody. Welcome back to the Benefits Cooldown. My name is Eric Silverman. That, everyone, is my good friend, Ed Legande. And Ed, last week, you asked me an incredible question that I am dying to know the answer from your point of view. And the question we posed last week was, are there such thing as benefits for white collar employees versus what benefits for blue collar employees, or even any collar in between? I gave my opinion, and I'm curious yours. Do benefits matter depending on the type of environment the employee works in, white collar versus blue collar? Go.
That's such a loaded question, honestly, at the end of the day. I think it has something to do with it, but definitely not everything. And I think, I believe we are doing everyone a disservice if we just start to segment types of benefits for types of employers at the end of the day, if that makes sense, right? Because at the end of the day, we've talked about this before, a human life is a human life. And, if I work for UPS versus working work for Google or something of that nature, I am still Ed Legande. You are still Eric Silverman at the end of the day. I'm still married to who I'm married to. I still have my kids at the end of the day. And so we're still going to go through the same trials and tribulations that we would, no matter what type of employer we have. Therefore, the types of benefits we have are more, accustomed to what I need as a father for my particular family, not necessarily because I work for UPS or Google, right? And so, for me, I believe perception is reality. And for us, the way we deliver these types of solutions, educate people on how it can benefit them at the end of the day. I mean, you mentioned it with that amazing story from last week on how we basically made the decision for the employer, right? In that particular situation, you decided that they didn't need the benefit. And that would have helped that particular human being, again, at the end of the day, with his spouse's situation with cancer and so on and so forth. And so there's millions of people going through the same type of situation. Who are we to decide that, a certain benefit is more important to someone than something else? Our goal, I believe, is not only to deliver the solution, but educate on how it can help them at the end of the day. And then again, provide a menu of options for the employee to select. Of course, we can only lead a horse to water, right? We can't make them select the particular benefit at the end of the day just because we believe it's a better solution for that member. But our goal is to provide them with the solution at the end of the day and to educate them on when, how, and why that particular solution would make sense, right? So again, if I'm a driver for UPS or if I'm sitting at a desk at, Google or doing whatever it is, type of industry, type of job, type of role at the end of the day, an accident plan may still be important to me because you and I have talked about this off camera at the end of the day. My son's now playing baseball. He got pegged in the hand the other day and, we almost had to take him to urgent care. Does it matter what type of job I have at the end of the day? No, he still got hurt. So that accident plan is still important for me and my family at the end of the day, right? So, again, I think our goal is to look at an organization and see how can we do a better job of delivering a plethora of different solutions without overwhelming people, of course, educating people on how it can help them, especially with the diverse workforce we're dealing with. Again, just because I'm of a certain age bracket and I've got a family at the end of the day doesn't mean someone in the same situation believes in the same way that money should be handled. The average person can't handle an emergency $600 bill, right? So at the end of the day, we cannot make these decisions on behalf of employees. Our goal is to educate, provide the deliverable, and just, again, provide the solutions and not make assumptions or make the decision on behalf of employers, nor on behalf of employees and their families. So that's how I feel.
I mean, look, they're considered voluntary, as I hate that term, but they're employee funded. So ultimately, if you make the benefit available and the employee isn't interested, terrific. But at least they had the option, right? I just don't like to make the decision for the employee. We're talking about human beings. We're talking about educated adults. Absolutely. Some adults may have a bigger or better or more robust education than others. but that's irrelevant. They're still able to make their own decision, and they should be given that right, in my opinion. So I appreciate you saying what you said. I completely agree. And, you know, this is great. I love it. Let's keep it going. This has been another great episode, in my opinion, and I'm sure yours, of the Benefits Cooldown. If you have any questions, thoughts, ideas, please drop them in the comments section below. If you have any ideas for new shows, let us know. Otherwise, we will see you next week on the Benefits Cooldown. I'm Eric Silverman. That, everybody, of course, is the one, the only, Ed Legande. Thanks, everybody.
See you next week.